It's lights out, and we are racing in Misano in Moto2. It's a really good start from that pole position by Vietti, although he's bogging down a little bit here, and Gonzalez and Acosta are going to sweep on the inside of him. He does fight back and keep Gonzalez at bay, and now he's attacking the middle on Acosta on the inside. That's going to be really tight, but it's Pedro Acosta then that's your early leader.
Here comes Arbolino then, up the inside of Sam Lowes, who isn't making it too easy for his teammate, but we're certainly not going to expect to see the two of them come together, although they have done, of course, on Italian tarmac in the past. This time, though, Arbolino cleanly passed his teammate, now up into seventh.
Arbolino then dispensing of his future Mark VDS Racing teammate, Philip Salac. Arbolino then now up inside the top six.
Someone's down.
Oh, it's Kinnett. It's Aaron Kinnett. Well, he is already Moto2's most prolific crasher in 2023. And unfortunately, that takes the tally up to 17. Down at 14 then, turn 14 goes Kinnett. And surely now, any slim hopes he had of being Moto2 world champion this year, well, they've ended in that moment. The front just going out from underneath him on the brakes into turn number 14. So Kinnett slips out of contention. Looking at the man in second place, trying to complete a fairy tale home win. Look at that. Celestino Vietti, how close do you want to having your home victory hopes extinguished in a millisecond? Superb save that by Celestino Vietti. Look at that. That was another replay. Look, what a shot. How on earth did he save that one?
Vietti was only a quarter of a second behind Acosta when they came through the third sector. That was the most drastic advantage he pulled out in the third sector so far.
I think he's lost rear. We just cut back right at this point. Clear evidence, isn't it? The big front end scare at turn one a couple laps ago. There as he tried to get the power on coming out of turn 14. This is just how hard he's having to work. How hard Acosta is pushing him. He is making mistakes galore as Vietti. That was into turn number four. Tony Arbolino then now.
He's through on Manuel Gonzalez.
This was the move then that Arbolino made on turn four into the Rio corner. Gonzalez tried to fight back, didn't he? But it just pitched him onto the inside line through turn six. That's where Arbolino had the big scare a few moments ago. This is why this young man stands head and shoulders of this Moto2 World Championship battle, but in particular this Misano Moto2 scrap. Look at the speed, look at the consistency, barely out of the 136s, all Grand Prix. Last corner left then for Pedro Acosta. Safe to say has been a Moto2 Misano masterclass from your World Championship leader. Pedro Acosta takes the checkered flag in commanding fashion. A start to finish victory for him.
Need more MotoGP action? Click here to get your fix.